उरट सुंदर वासुदेव त्राण करता, रामानंद सखा भट्ट कुल क्लेश हरता। गौरांग शतनाम टेक्स्ट 18। उरट सुंदर ही इज लाइक मोल्टन गोल्ड, ब्यूटिफुल लाइक गोल्ड। उरट सुंदर वासुदेव त्राण करता एंड ही इज अ डिलीवरर ऑफ द लेपर वासुदेव। रामानंद सखा, he acted like the friend of Ramananda Rai. Bhattakul Klesha Harta, and Bhattakul refers to the family of Venkat Bhatta, Gopal Bhatta, and Venkat Bhatta and Gopal Bhatta and his uncle also, who later on became Prabodhananda Saraswati. So here what is being said is, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the deliverer of all of them. So how exactly did Chaitanya Mahaprabhu deliver all of them? He delivered them by bestowing his mercy in different ways. So let's go over these names one by one. Urata Sundara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was beautiful like molten gold. It was extraordinary, incomparable, and breathtaking beauty. Beauty that he exhibited had no parallels in the world. And in fact, many people became attracted to him just because he was so astonishingly beautiful. Now normally, if a person is beautiful, that person is very careful to preserve one's beauty. And if something is going to spoil the beauty, say touching something which is not good looking, which is ugly, then a beautiful person will keep something ugly very far away. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced the leper Vasudeva. Now this leper was such that even ordinary people would not touch him. What to speak of somebody who is extraordinarily beautiful. So it was believed that lepers might... leprosy was a contagious disease. That was the reason, and lepers are also considered social outcasts in some ways. So, and he was afflicted by such advanced leprosy that even there were insects on his body, and these insects would worms would be eating his body, and sometimes they would fall off. So, such was Vasudeva's compassion that he would think, oh, if the flesh of my body is the food for them, then then let them eat this food. Who am I to deprive them of the food? And you pick them up and put them on his body once again. So now Purata Sundara Vasudeva Trana Karata. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to this leper Vasudev and embraced him. And as he embraced him, what happened? Far from, generally if a very attractive, good looking person touches something ugly, that thing will also that dirt or ugliness will contaminate the beautiful person. But far from that, it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu transferred his beauty to that leper Vasudeva, and he became not only free from leprosy, but he developed a effulgent golden form. So Vasudeva Tranakarta. So he was freed from leprosy. And then he could have been delighted. Oh, this mortal affliction which I had. It was not exactly mortal in the sense of it was going to kill him. It may have killed him in the long run, but it was mortal in the sense that it was a life which most people would have considered worse than death. This affliction is gone. He didn't celebrate on that. He thought that I'll become proud. And because Lord Chaitanya has shown so special mercy on me, and he says, please protect me from this pride. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him, you chant the holy names, and speak about Krishna, then you will stay free from pride. So, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu transformed his, removed his leprosy and gave him a golden form, is a miracle of his potency. But along with that, another miracle is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually embraced him at all. That is a miracle of his love. So, Purata Sundara Vasudeva Trana Karta Ramananda Sakha.
Ramayana Sakha refers to his name as he is the friend of Ramanand Rai. Now, Ramanand Rai, we can see that in different ways. If Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in the mood of Krishna, then Ramanand Rai is Arjuna. And there is a question answer here. The only thing is that the direction of the question answer is reversed, with Arjuna answering and Krishna asking. And if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in the mood of Radharani, is Radharani, then Ramanand Rai is Lalita Sakhi, is Vishakha Sakhi. So, both ways, they are friends, you could say. Female friends are called as Sakhi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramanand Rai both are male bodies, so they are Sakhas. So, he had a very intimate relationship, which in his other forms was in the form of friendship. And here also, it was very intimate. They discussed very confidential topics, where they ascended to the topics which are the zenith of the discussions about love of God. Then, Ramananda Sakha, Bhattakula Kleshaharta. Bhattakula Kleshaharta. Bhattakula is the dynasty of the Bhattas. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went in South India to Srirangakshetra, where he stayed in the house of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. And therein, now from the point of Gaudiya Vaishnavism, Krishna Bhakti is the highest. And although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted that Vaikuntha is real and those who go to Vaikuntha also attend liberation, but there is a special sweetness to Krishna Bhakti. So he brought all of them. So those who are deprived from the nectar of Krishna Bhakti, he offered them the nectar of Krishna Bhakti. So they were Vaishnavas, but they were Vishnu Bhaktas. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought them from the mood of Vishnu Bhakti in Aishwarya to the mood of Krishna Bhakti in Madhurya. So that separation of Krishna for them, he ended, which is the sweet and extraordinary glory of Lord Chaitanya. Thank you.